Hello, everyone. Thanks for coming. I'll tell you about the user story of Kirin. I'm Atsushikoga from NTT Data, and I'm responsible for OpenStack private cloud implementation project at Kirin. I used to be working as Unix and Oracle database engineer in early 2000s. And in later 2000s, I've been implementing the largest real-time billing system in Japan, involving CEP, which is well known for big data analysis these days. I've been working on BDI OpenStack in recent years, and I'm going to work on IoT for the next. Now let me introduce NTT Data, the company I belong to. As you know, NTT Data is the most major systems integrator in Japan. We target to become one of the global top five companies in this midterm. So NTT Data Group is working on improving operational efficiency, though cooperation of group companies and organizations. Kirin's OpenStack cloud case that I'm going to show today is also one of the those which we cooperated with R&D department. Later on, the leader of this project, Kakinuma-san, is going to explain technical details. There are three main IT service segments: public, financial, and enterprise. Latest NTT Data Group net sales is more than 1,500 billion, and 40% of the sales are earned by public and financial segments. Global business and enterprise segments share 20% each. Considering its market size, the enterprise segment I belong to has more chance to grow its share. In order to grow our share in the market, we are working on various technologies such as BDI, OpenStack, and IoT. Here are our activities on global business. The NTT Data Group also expands its business in worldwide. By March 2015, the NTT Data Group's coverage further increased to 42 countries and 76,000 employees around the world. The number of employees is doubled in 7 years since 2009, when I was in management department. What surprised me is the fact that there are more employees in overseas than in Japan. As a member of this global group, I strongly realize the necessity of studying English. As you know, one of the most famous brewery company in Japan, Kirin, NTT Data established alliance contact with Kirin Holdings in 2012 and has been contributing to reinforce IT strategies and system engineering of Kirin Group. Kirin own group companies in overseas as well, such as Lion and Brazil King. Sales in Japan and in the other countries are 50-50. Project overview. There are approximately 400 systems, and most of them are developed from scratch. In order to meet various business requirements, such as Japanese commercial practice, Kirin prefers developing from scratch rather than implementing packaged products. Kirin's platform consisted of various data centers, so that creaky infrastructure was a big issue for Kirin. Kirin had been managing various types of infrastructure, Windows, Linux, Unix, mainframe, and so on. There are 2,000 servers or so. Almost half of those 2,000 servers had been facing EOSL in 2050 and 60, and they were in desperate need of replacement. Furthermore, Kirin has been working on standardization involving enterprise architecture. During this midterm, Kirin focused on improving quality rather than reducing the cost, and haven't worked on reducing IT cost related to infrastructure. With this background, Kirin aimed drastic reduction in infrastructure costs as one of the coming midterm IT management strategies. The project we are introducing today is one of the cases of achieving these management strategies. Next, why OpenStack? There are three reasons we choose OpenStack. First, it's sophisticated. As you know, OpenStack consists of simple components and has easily understanding structure. It makes customer feel reliable when its architecture is visible. Moreover, there are a large number of practices of OpenStack all over the world. NTT Data 2 had so many experience of using OpenStack. In addition to this, bug reports and quick bug fix by huge community is also attractive. Secondly, flexibility. What we were implementing was PaaS, not IaaS. Although OpenStack is the software for IaaS, there are many ways to customize it to be PaaS. Since our PaaS has complicated requirements, it had been quite important that we can customize easily. Moreover, from cost-cutting point of view, it had been also important that we can start small, because replacement should be proceeded step by step for each server's EOSL. At last, vendor neutral. NTT Data is a leading system integrator that doesn't produce hardware. And so, selecting optimal hardware for each customer requirement is one of our important strategies. As an OpenStack project in NTT Data, have involved various hardware. It was one of the deciding factors that we can propose without any hardware constraints. There are three challenges. Full automation, mass migration, and drastic cost reduction. We fully automated at pass level. At this infrastructure, we automated not only installation of OS or middleware, but also testing. This is today's main topic, and it's going to be explained later. Next thing is mass migration. To be honest, it is not a big issue implementing OpenStack, but migration. Migration large number of mission critical enterprise systems within minimum downtime has been a big issue for us. And now on, it is in progress. Lastly, drastic cost reduction. Most customers are interested in IT cost reduction, and it's not only in Japan. Under the circumstance, excess cost related to IT operations should be revised. By making best use of OpenStack, we aimed improvement of operational efficiency. Especially, we automated repeated operation process. We have just finished implementing OpenStack a few days ago. I'd like to show you how it worked. Kirin had been spending large amount of money for server operation, especially in designing, building, and testing. In order to state different requirements for each user, Kirin had to hold a large number of engineers, so that it was hard to reduce the operational costs. So we took approach on automation by applying OpenStack. By making use of OpenStack, server building and testing are automated completely. Surprisingly, estimated operational cost reduction is 75%. Customers are satisfied with this effect, and it is certain that this will be achieved. Although it has just started, we keep working on further cost reduction by taking actions such as customizing.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming. I'm Motoki Akinuma from NTT Data. I'm in charge of implementation of OpenStack in Kirin. In my part, I'd like to talk about the details of Kirin OpenStack. This is a technical session. This talk includes the what we developed and how we developed OpenStack. Okay, let's start the second part. As Koga-san mentioned before, we have implemented the OpenStack in Kirin. The Kirin OpenStack is fully automated and optimized private cloud system. And the Kirin OpenStack is pod system. There are three features of Kirin OpenStack. The first feature is deployment automation. So it enables to us easy and quick deployment. The second feature is testing automation. So I used and implemented some new server testing tools to evaluate the server quality, automatically. The third feature is consistent inventory management. We used OpenStack as a simple inventory management system. Okay, the first feature is deployment automation. In addition to implement the OpenStack, we have developed a new web application. That web application is called as Kirin EA. EA means enterprise architecture. So the Kirin EA user sends a deployment request to that application. Then the Kirin EA runs the build process on the background automatically. The combination of Kirin EA and OpenStack is called as Kirin OpenStack. A Kirin EA, that web application we build, enables to us three operating system deployment and 11 middleware deployment and over 800 parameter setting. As you can see, the name of operating systems and middlewares and parameters. So the user can select the any combination of pattern of operating systems and middleware and parameter. Here is a sample screen of Kirin EA. The user can change the password of system administrator and root, and select the number of disk, and change the size of disk, and set the name of drive letter and mount point. And also, the user can change the host name and set the number of network card and setting the IP address statistically. And also, user can select the middleware which they need to install as a checkbox. Of course, they can select the version of middleware. And next screen is the parameter input screen. This is a sample of Apache HTTP server. So when the user selects the middleware as middleware install of Apache HTTP server, so the user can change the parameter or kernel settings, syscontrol.conf, and sysconfig parameter, and http.conf parameter. The inputted value on this screen is the default inputted value is not an operating system and middleware default value, but this parameter is NTT Data's recommended value. Our deployment automation is not only install the middleware and operating system, but also this deployment automation can orchestrate with other systems, such as Big IP or Hidemas agent. So according to the request from the user, the Kirin EA register the instance with Big IP or Hidemas monitoring manager after the deployment automation. It's a very useful function. Of course, suspense and resume works. So the, according to the instance stop or start request from the user, the user Kirin EA suspends the balancing or monitoring settings from Big IP or Hidemas monitoring manager before stop instances. I think this is a very user-friendly function. The second topic is testing automation. in the beginning of this project, we had one mission. The mission is getting automatically tested server. The reason why we had such mission is because in NTT Data, we have to test the server according to the NTT Data standard test cases. But it's really heavy work for us. It usually takes 3 to 4 hours per server. So to be honest, I don't like it. So I wanted to change that situation definitely. So consequently, we implement the testing automation. The testing automation enables to reduce the cost almost exactly zero, only 5 minutes per one deployment compared to usual way. So the key testing automation consists of various tests, as on the slide. For example, parameter test means that checking whether the inputted value from user is set or is set correctly or not. In order to implement the testing tools, we used and implemented two tools. We used the first server spec. The server spec is very famous and popular server testing tools. This tool is developed by a Japanese engineer and written in Ruby. Server spec can check the parameter and server state and the command result or error log and etc. As you can see on the slide, the code of server spec is very simple and easy to understand and easy to write. Approximately 7,000 lines server spec code I wrote in this project. To testing the big IP state or Hinemos monitoring manager or Oracle test, it's very difficult to adapt the server spec. So we developed some Linux bash script for testing the big IP and Hinemos and Oracle. And the test result is reported automatically. Here is the sample of a test report. I'm sorry, this is written in Japanese, so. But this test report is very simple. There are the test result summary, OK or NG, and server information, IP address, or host name, and test score for each server. In the case of Linux deployment with full middleware, for example, Apache HTTP server and Tomcat and Mojo JK, JP1 and Hinemos agent and security software, over 140 test cases will be executed and will be reported automatically. The third topic is consistent inventory management. Before Kirin OpenStack implementation, in Kirin, IP assets were managed in a consistent way. So it means it was really totally difficult to know how many servers we have, and how many servers will be EOL, and how many servers are installed Windows Server 2003. So last year, we have investigated the software and the hardware inventory. It came out that amazing amount of servers were there. So there is a big inventory issue in Kirin. So to resolve that issue, we use the metadata service. Metadata service is one of the functions of OpenStack Nova. So once the server is deployed, the metadata is added automatically. Here is a sample of metadata. Metadata is very simple. There are application number and sector name and IP addresses, and the name of OS and the resource amount and the name of middleware and etc. So the Kirin EA collects that metadata and creates the server inventory list automatically. Then the user request the server list, they can get the server list anytime. And Kirin also manages servers which are moved from the other structure. There are many servers migrated to Kirin OpenStack by P2Play or V2Play from EOL server. So when the operator migrates to the server, to the Kirin OpenStack, so they add the metadata for each server. So finally, they can get the server inventory list as on the same way. Next, I'll tell you the, how we implemented OpenStack. Installation process of OpenStack was completely easy. In this project, we adopt IBM OpenStack. IBM OpenStack provides each OpenStack component as a virtual server. So the installation process is only starts the virtual server on the controller cluster and run some shell script, that's all. As for our implementation of availability, we use the VMware HA. So the virtual server on the controller cluster or computer cluster is done. The failover is done automatically. Okay, finally, we adopted OpenStack version is Ice House, and adopted virtual technology is VMware ESX. We didn't use KVM. The reason why we adopt VMware is our customer have used VMware for a long time, and easy to migrate by using the VMware converter tool. And we use Nova, and Cinder, and Neutron, and Keystone, that's all. So it means we implemented OpenStack as simple as possible. But it's enough. It's enough. So fortunately, we have had no trouble regarding of OpenStack. I don't think this is the best solution for implementing OpenStack. However, this is one of the answers, I think. So my point is, implementing OpenStack is not our primary purpose. Our primary purpose is to meet the customer's requirement. Our customer's requirement is stable and cost-effective, easy to use, and easy to operate platform. OK, my part is end. This presentation will be wrapped up from Koga-san.
Our last summary and suggestions. This time, we have implemented OpenStack at Kirin. There are many OpenStack implementing cases in Japan. However, most of them are for IT vendors. So that success of implementation of OpenStack at non-IT company has a big meaning. At last, here is our suggestions. This time, we implementing path by customizing OpenStack. For next step, additional features of path on OpenStack would be helpful. We are also willing to work on OpenStack linkage with public clouds like AWS. Thank you.